Michael, how are you?
I found something really interesting.
The whole housing market is propped up on these bad loans. They will fail.
The housing market is rock solid.
It's a time bomb.
Well, first of all, congratulations on this movie. It's fantastic. And we keep hearing that, you know, it's up for comedy awards and things like that, but there's some deadly serious stuff in this.
Yeah, but I don't know if you could have told the story any other way. That's why I think Adam was such a great choice to kind of steer the ship a little bit. It's very dense material. It's very esoteric, heady stuff. So without that humor and that lightness brought in as well, it would have been a chore to sit through.
It looked like you had fun times on the set because most of your scenes were with Finn and then with Brad, and now those guys are pretty funny, right?
Yeah, it was a great time. We were all having a real blast over there. It never felt like we were trying to get a joke with the improvisation. It always felt like we were trying to advance a story or kind of clarify these complicated points or this jargon in a way that maybe gave it a little more passion, a little bit more heart. But we were really having a good time. We had a good few months down in New Orleans.
And the real characters, I should say that the people that your characters are based on, they actually showed up to the set, right?
Yeah, we were very lucky to have a lot of very supportive people around us while making it. Otherwise, I think it would have been impossible to do.
Does it make you nervous, though, playing someone that actually exists as opposed to a fictional character?
I think at first it's a little nerve-wracking. Especially when you know that you're going to be talking to them and they're going to be there on the actual days you're shooting. I think a great example of that was there's a phone call in the film where Charlie calls his mother. And originally that was written that I just said, I'm going to go call my mom as the collapse starts to happen. And then it picks up after the phone call and says, oh, she says I should be on lithium or something like that. But because I got to talk to Charlie, I had his whole phone call mapped out, what he said to his mom, how he was really feeling. And Adam was like, let's go for it. Let's try and do the phone call. And now that lives in the film, and that wouldn't have been able to happen if we didn't have Charlie there. Yeah.
Well, I felt like I knew quite a bit about the housing crisis, but I feel like I learned quite a bit from watching this film.
Yeah, educational but entertaining filmmaking.
Yeah. Oh, what did you learn? What was the most surprising thing to you?
What's so great about this story is that it really kind of gets to the roots of why all this went down and where the banks sort of were either stupid or greedy, and where the ratings agencies failed, and where the government was just not paying attention. So kind of the complexity of all that was revealed by the script and the book.
Hey, thank you so much for being with us, and congratulations again.
Thank you so much.
The banks and the fraud of the American people. Now we can kick them in the teeth.
Okay, here we go.
You target strippers.
With bad loans.
Mm-hmm. And they're all cash rich.
I'm not going to be able to refinance.
On all my loans?
What do you mean, all your loans?
I have five houses. And a condo.